Here it is. Festiniog Railway, Port Madoc. Britain's pioneer narrow-gauge railway.
Pioneer indeed. The Festiniog Railway became the first narrow-gauge railway to carry fare-paying passengers as long ago as 1865. And now, 100 years later, we move first into the booking hall at Harbour Station.
Can I have 2 first-class tickets all the way, please?
Tannerball?
Yes, please. And my dog. Do I have to pay
for my
dog?
Yes, you have to pay for a dog. That's an extra 6 pence.
Oh, thank you. Well, 1 adult and 1 child, please.
1 adult and 1 child, Tannerball.
Yes, please.
Right.
Yes, please.
That's 8 and 9, please.
Oh, and can I have a guide, please?
Then out onto the platform. One of the double Fairlie engines arrives and couples up to its train.
Come along. Oh, here's the engine.
And the guard checks tickets, locks the doors and prepares for departure.
Tickets, please. Thank you. Any more tickets?
Any more tickets, please.
So the train sets off along the cob. We pass Boston Lodge Works, where the 2 double Fairlies were built, and then stop at Boston Lodge Holt. Again, the train sets off among trees and wonderful scenery through the peace of the countryside. The train crew check tickets in the observation car.
Shillings, please, madam, for the supplement for the observation.
And business begins in the buffet car.
2 tubs of ice cream, please. Anybody want any pop?
Yes, please.
Bottle of pop, please.
1 and 6, please. Thank you.
Under the main road at Rue Place Bridge. Passing over British Railways' main line, the train stops at Minforth, the important interchange station with Western Region. The driver blows up his brake and we start again from Minforth. There's the familiar noise of the large ejector as it recreates the vacuum for the brake. Thank you. through Penryn and over the main road level crossing. A mile or so of pastoral country, only slight curves, and on good track we run at about 20 miles an hour. Next, by the 6 mile post, round Tyler's Curve, the sharpest on the line, and into Tyler's Cutting. Then half a mile on, a long left-hand curve at Trebagel, leading into the small Horseshoe Bend. Not a yard of straight track here, as we practically reverse our direction, winding steeply up through the trees and into Whistling Curve. That whistle is to herald our approach to Tanny Buch. Let's go ahead and wait for the train, hearing first that whistle across the valley. Tanny Buch, the present top of the line. And here the engine takes water and runs round the train, while passengers may perhaps refresh themselves in the buffet served by Mrs. Jones, the station mistress, in her Welsh national dress. Then on time, the train loads up, and with a whistle and a wave, sets off on the return run to Port Maverick.